If I went like this, what would you do? How would you defend yourself if I tried to strike you here? How would you? What kind of move would you do? If I went like that,
punch me in the stomach. Then
all right, let's try this. So what if I went like this? What would you do?
That's a terrible move.
He's a wrestler. I'm trying to get some moves.
Have you ever seen the movie, what's it called?
Give me something.
Napoleon
Give me something.
Dynamite?
Yeah, I did.
Right, wait,
I have.
Grab my wrist with this hand. Other hand.
This, like that? I like it.
Yeah. But that's not really a wrestling move. I don't think.
No,
that's just like a second Napoleon Dynamite move.
That's a Napoleon Dynamite move.
With a rock.
When you're doing like that guy, with the pants.
You're doing like arm locks and shit like that?
Well, I don't. It's all about center of gravity, you know, where you just, you're trying to get someone off balance and you're trying to trick them and then just, you go shoot.
That's hot. I like it.
So how long have you been wrestling?
3 years old. My dad was a wrestler.
3 years old?
Yeah, 3 years old. With my dad, he was an Olympic wrestler for Team Canada. So I think I kind of just fell into it. Now, I don't think I had a real choice, but it's my favorite sport. So, yeah.
It's cool, man.
So to prepare you for acting, is that part of your?
I think if you can last 9 minutes in a wrestling ring, where you want to dry heave afterwards, I think you can do lots of stuff. Although some acting stuff can be quite daunting.
Can make you dry heave, yeah, too. Yeah.
So can you survive a 2 minute rollout with Sam Rockwell? Is that?
Well,
he could take me.
No. He'd punch me in the face because he's a boxer. So
I punched you in the face.
No, yes,
really?
He would punch me in the face.
Oh, no, I'm not a boxer. I can throw a combo, but I'm not a boxer.
He's a boxer.
So how do you guys work together when you get on this? I mean, obviously you have a script on something like this, but are you figuring out the relationship ahead of time, or are you just messing around like this as you go and saying lines? Or
I think Sam really helped me to feel really comfortable right off the bat. He introduced me to boxing, actually, and we did a little bit of shadow boxing and also lots of things. I mean, just hang out. He's an easy guy to hang out with. He's really nice and
fairly nice.
Fairly.
Well, you know.
Yeah, you know. Then there's those other times. I think, you know, you want to have the time off camera also kind of generate some energy for the time on camera. You know, you want it to be, they parallel each other, I think, a little bit.
So do you have much time off camera on this, or?
Well, sure, yeah. There's a lot of waiting around and stuff like that, but what I mean is, I guess we want to bring the sort of looseness, the relaxed nature we had off camera into the scenes, so that we, you know, get some of that realistic energy in there.
And of course, we got to go down the slides together. All the water park stuff. So we just go to work every day and kind of blow off all the scenes and just go on the whatnot.
Yeah, yeah, basically.
So did you have, when the script came to you, you go, okay, I'm now Bill Murray, is that?
Yeah, essentially, that's pretty much right away. I mean, you could just tell that that's kind of what it was, and whatever my version of that is. So it was pretty instant. I just looked at it and it was like, yeah, okay. I'll do it.
Is there a Sam Rockwell thing now? Do you feel like you're getting?
God, I hope not. Jeez.
Sam Rockwell scripts.
God, I hope not. I hope I change it up enough. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, you know, people love to type you, you know. Mm-hmm. But I hope we change it up as much as we can, you know.
Yeah, and he actually gave me the movie Meatballs on the film. He actually made me watch it.
Well, you have to see it. I mean,
yeah, I'd never seen it.
So you did.
I gave it to you, right?
Yeah, I don't know if I ever gave it back.
I gave you a couple of movies, right?
Yeah, he gave me a...
We gave you Hot Tub Time Machine, because that's Rob. Rob's
yeah,
in that.
Yeah, I'd seen Hot Tub Time Machine before, but Talladega Nights, you just had that.
Talladega Nights, my beloved Leslie Bibb is in Talladega Nights, so I gave you that.
Uh-huh. And there was a couple other great ones, and he had this whole list, 100 movies.
Yeah, we were writing down, we were all like taking a collection. Everybody was putting in movies that he needs to see, so we wrote down all kinds of movies. Have you seen Badlands yet?
No.
Have you seen One Flew Over the Cuckoo's
Nest?
Yes,
definitely.
Okay, that's good. That's a step in the right direction.
Yes, definitely.
Have you seen... You're not ready for The Deer Hunter. Have you seen The Deer Hunter?
I have not seen it, but my...
Maybe wait a couple years, yeah.
My dad said I should watch it. He said it was one of his...
All right, so you're ready for it, then. If your dad says you're ready, then check out The Deer Hunter.
So it wasn't just summer movies. It was all kinds of movies.
No, it was just getting his film encyclopedia up to par.
Because I'm below average and...
Yeah, man, get it up, dude.
I've seen a lot of movies, actually, great movies before I met Sam. The Green Mile. I don't know if you've seen it.
I have.
It's one of the greatest movies of all time in my book.
It's a pretty darn good movie.
Yeah,
and I hear there's this guy Sam Rockwell in it.
He's
a creepy dude.
No, he's amazing.
Well, he's like 7'3" in that movie. It's amazing. Black. It's very impressive performance.
Jeffrey DeMunn, Barry Pepper, David Morris, Tom Hanks.
That's a great movie.
The late, great Michael Clark Duncan. The late, great Michael Jeter was in that. Uh-huh. All kinds of good actors. Graham Greene. Yeah. Huh.
So how was this for you? How did you get dragged in? You just go to auditions? Or
how did you get dragged in?
How did I get dragged into this? I got the script, and I put it on tape for them, and they asked me...
Yeah.
To come out to Los Angeles, and I said
that's not enough. I need more back end.
Yeah, I came out, and I was in one of the best auditions I think ever, most enjoyable I think for me, because Nat and Jim were both there, and they're laughing up a storm, and just really made me feel comfortable enough to do whatever I had to do with the character. I think not nervous at all. So yeah, I really thank them for that. I think they helped me to get the part by being so down to earth. So,
was it scary to carry this much of the movie?
I worked every day. I worked on the film, and I.
But were you nervous before anticipating it? Were you anticipating the what was going to happen? You don't know.
I don't think I ever felt nervous.
Have you been doing that TV show for a while?
Yeah, I've been acting for about 5 or 6 years now, so yeah. I kind of knew a little bit what to expect, but I'd never had a role this lead role before. And. But I hope that all, if any acting jobs in the future would be as enjoyable as this one, because I worked 5 days a week, but it felt like it's seamless. I was working at a water park and in the beach, and some of the funniest people on earth were there. So I was never unhappy. I was never stressed out, really. I just had a great time.
So did the emotional stuff come easily to you? Because you're like kind of a straight man in this show, in the movie, particularly with Sam. And
yeah, I mean, it can be quite, you have to really think about it, and you have to really think about what's going to make sure that it's going to get there. I think one of the great scenes, one of the great memories I'll have was me and Sam filming the scene on top of the water slide after the party, and I tell him all about what's happening at home, and he just went above and beyond with being so generous and just helping me out with all that stuff, and I think it really, really helped me out. So,
you were great
thanks.
In that. You were great in that scene. We shot a couple... different ways that scene. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So is that work you guys are doing together in the moment, like between takes, or are you doing it before you get to the set that day?
Well, we ran the line. We would run the scenes, before, just on our own, we'd run the scenes.
Yeah, and I can't remember specific examples, but I just remember that he was just... He was there to push me. He'd say, "You push me," and I'd grab him.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And you get your energy up, and so...
Yeah, that's right. John Turturro taught me that. You kind of push up, and you kind of like... Yeah. You put your hands like
you
like
get
this.
The energy
and you kind of get your
and then
gets your blood flowing a little bit. Yeah,
so
that's a good energy trick.
Yeah, so
like,
I'm very
you get like a little
lucky.
Spacey, and it was hot sun too. We're in the hot sun, so that'll tire you out too.
Mm-hmm. Do you have energy issues, or I mean, because you always, I guess people expect you to be up.
No,
not at all. I think, you know, I'm pretty good, you know. We work out, right? We have good energy.
But like Allison Jenny was saying, it was like exhausting playing her character because it was like so intense, and then she's not really that intense, but...
Sure, sure. No, she's a whirlwind. She's a tornado in the movie.
But you are kind of too.
Yeah, I was too. I had a lot of text, I had to spit out a lot of dialogue, you know? Mm-hmm. That was challenging. I had to really know those lines backwards and forwards. Mm-hmm. And there were walk and talk, a lot of walk and talks, you know.
The big God
Yeah.
Is that what it's called? The Goodfellas. They called the Goodfellas
right.
shot
where we introduced the big where they fall, slide. Yeah,
where they just follow you around the whole park and he does this whole thing. And then later Duncan kind of does the same thing for his friend.
There were a few of those kind of walk and talks with lots of dialogue.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I had to spit it out pretty quickly, so that was challenging, yeah.
Is that the fun of it? I mean, when you read a script like this, is that what's going to be the grabs you? What's
the fun of it is creating this character and having that stuff come to life, you know, and really breathe life into it and come up, make it feel spontaneous. That's always the
he did it 100 different ways. He did every and there everyone was hilarious. And I think there's one story I want to share when he's yelling on the loud mic something about
that was funny.
herpes and while we were filming she was one of the
heads of the park, right?
Yeah, she
got very upset there. Understandably, I had to apologize, but I was just trying to do stuff to make us laugh and stuff, you know. And I forgot that there were kids
too
there.
Yeah.
On a loudspeaker.
Kids trying to enjoy their time at a water park, and all they hear is.
Yeah. That was. I sometimes wanted to do the rated R version, but that's all right. They always took. They pulled me. They pulled me back a little.
Well, do you ever miss? Is that part of your work? Is that you?
I'm always rated R. People take me into the PG realm. I'm often rated X. I'm definitely like always going in that direction, and I have to sort of tone it down sometimes.
But do you go too far with the comedy itself, with the stylizing things, or?
No, I always want to keep it real. You know, even if you're goofing around, I like to have it rooted and grounded. You know, I don't want it to be over. I hate overacting, which I've done some of that. I've schmacked it a lot in my lifetime, but I try not to, and try to keep it real.
Well, it's one of the things in like Seven Psychopaths where your character has to keep it close enough to the reality.
Well, that's a theatrical person, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like he's a theatrical character.
It's a great movie.
Just like Kathy Bates in Misery is kind of a theatrical character, or you know, Peter O'Toole in My Favorite Year is a theatrical character, you know, but yeah. And so is Owen. Yeah, Owen's a bit theatrical. Yeah.
So do you like playing those guys better than playing the quiet ones, or is there any
There's more to chew on, I guess. I like the quiet ones too, you know. I did a movie called Single Shot, where this is more of a quiet kind of thing, or like Conviction is more. I enjoy both, you know. But it's good. This guy's a real extrovert. We had a lot of fun together.
Are you a closet extrovert? Is that the
Well, he's a wrestler, so that's pretty.
Well, I don't have any sort of great improv that Sam really brought to this.
Yes, you did. Come on.
I mean, we had a couple jokes, but I don't know if I'm funny or not. I don't know.
You're funny. Funny in the head.
Yeah.
Come on.
Do you want to be funny?
Yeah, I'd love to. Well, everybody wants to be funny. Like, but I don't want to be that guy who's trying too hard at school. That guy who is...
Class clown?
Yeah, but you always want to... Try it. I don't know. You don't always want to be thinking that you have to be the funny guy, but it's fun when you're funny and people laugh at you. That's one of the best feelings, I think.
Yeah.
Were you a class clown?
Class clown. I don't know. Sometimes maybe. Yeah, I guess sometimes I was.
Did you want to be an actor in high school?
I grew up in it. My parents were actors, so I kind of grew up in the theater and stuff. I did plays when I was a little kid, and so I grew up in it.
So you never pushed away. You never.
Huh?
You never wanted to go off and be a CPA or?
No. I was just, I messed around with it for a long time and then got serious about it when I was about 24. Mm. Started to really take it more seriously. But I was in it, since I was a kid.
So were you studying when you were 24? I mean, is that what
I was. I studied very young. I mean, in a way, my childhood was there was some training, just inadvertently. But I became because I was around actors and on the stage and stuff. But then I studied 2 years of Sanford Meisner technique with William Esper, who's pretty much the primary East Coast teacher there, and my coach Terry Knickerbocker, and Maggie Flanagan is a great teacher, and then some of the so they influenced me. But I did 2 years of that training, and that's I think when I got more, you know, serious about it.
Did you want to be a working actor? Was working actor your goal? Was it being a star? Was it being?
I didn't know what was going to happen. I was just kind of up for the adventure. I liked the lifestyle because I'd seen it. Although it's not an easy lifestyle when you're coming up, because I saw my mother struggling as an actress, but I enjoyed the adventure, you know, the bohemian adventure of it. You know, I thought it was an exciting lifestyle, and so I think that's what was fun about it at first. And then there seemed to be, when I realized what it was to be a good actor, there was a responsibility there to, you know what you're doing and have technique and be consistent and that kind of stuff, you know.
Well, the directors kind of clicked into you pretty quickly.
Yeah, I got lucky. You know, I started working early, but I didn't really know what I was doing for a while until I, you know, really was like maybe in my 30s probably, you know.
And then it just came to you one day, or you...
Well, I think it's an accumulative effect, you know. Meisner says it takes 20 years to become an actor. Mm. And I think he's probably right. You know, I've been doing it for about that, and yeah. So I think I'm starting to get the hang of it. You know, it's a tough racket. You know,
lucky you're in your 20s for the way way back. So then we finally got a kid actor on it.
Exactly. Maybe one of these days when I'm like 36.
Well, you got 15 years to go or so.
Yes, I do have.
Are you going to be around 15 years from now? Is this your goal, or
are you going to be? Are you going to be an actor after you're 18? Are you going to be a wrestler? What are you going to do?
I don't think I'm going to be a wrestler. It's too physically demanding, I think. And
you're going to be a doctor, a lawyer? You're going to be an actor? What do you want to do?
I've loved every moment of acting so far. I think it would be great to maybe explore, maybe in college or something, how, like Sam was saying earlier, script development, all those things would be nice to know about. So
yeah.
But,
a lot of good schools and places.
What do you love about it? What are you connecting with that's making you happy?
You like the cappuccinos that they bring you?
Yeah,
the egg whites,
the Diet Cokes.
Diet Cokes, yeah.
the best way I can explain is I've always loved film. Like I said, my parents, I think, ever since I was 10, I was watching movies like The Green Mile, and maybe that's not. Maybe the most appropriate movie for a 10-year-old, but I've always identified with those films, and just I think the way I act is I just try to bring whatever I can out of life and all the movies I've ever seen, and just try to bring it that way. But
do you have the excitement when you're on the set? Is that what turns you on about?
Yeah, I have a great time. Ever since I started doing background work about 5 years ago, I just fell in love with it, and I think I had the excitement for it, and the long days were I just never wanted to turn away from it. So yeah, I had a great time.
Did you watch Moon before the movie, or did you wait till you're actually on set?
Which one, Moon?
Moon, yeah.
I hadn't seen Moon. Actually, Rob Corddry told me to watch it. He said Sam was robbed of an Oscar, and then when I watched it, I agreed.
I like that Rob Corddry.
He's
a good man.
No, he's a great guy, and everybody on the film was so
great. I paid him to do that. I paid him to tell
him. No, he didn't. He thinks very highly of you, and I think you think very highly of him.
And I like Rob.
But I love Moon, and Seventh Psychopaths is a great movie. No, it's... But,
So are you sick of being robbed of Oscars, Sam? I mean, you must be...
Yeah, God damn it!
Well, he hasn't... Like, when did you hit the 20-year mark? So
the 20-year mark. I hit it a while ago.
I'm still waiting for an Oscar for Matchstick Man. I'm still waiting for an Oscar for Moon.
They're going to bring those films back to the next
Oscars. Let's release them again. Yeah. Hey, man, you know, that's, you know, all that stuff, whatever, you know.
Great films.
It is what it is.
And they're there.
Yeah, I mean, Oscar Schmosker.
Were you one to get concerned about it or into it? Or
you know, I have a couple of nice little trinkets over the years. I got the Berlin Silver Bear, which was probably the biggest, you know, honor as far as that stuff goes, you know. Mm-hmm. But I'm happy with just getting nice parts, yeah. You know, and doing good parts, you know.
Lots of money.
Keeping it different. Money's good, too.
It does seem like the first part of, like, a line in every review of every Sam Rockwell movie is, you know, the Oscar that's coming. It's like, people just adore you.
And oh, that's nice. Well, that's nice to hear. That's nice to hear.
Do you feel it? Do you get the sense of that in the world?
I do feel a nice, I get a lot of nice love from people, and I really appreciate it. I do feel blessed to be, you know.
He deserves it.
Hey, man. Thanks, man.
Well, it's interesting with, like, seven
there you go. Just take the whole thing. Take the whole thing.
Take the whole thing.
Take the credit cards, the whole thing.
Right? But with, like, Psychopaths, it's kind of like the room for you, you know, like, the way that people feel about Chris Walken still, and, you know, anytime that he's there,
that.
They want to see that. Or Woody, or, you know. That movie was kind of filled with people who people just like.
You know what? That was really a smorgasbord of, that was really, I mean, you know. It's like, that was, I said, Woody, Colin, Chris. Yeah, Woody, Colin, Chris, me, Tom Waits.
Tom Waits.
Mean, that's like five Elvises, you know. Kind of. I don't want to give myself too much credit, but it really is like five fucking kooky guys, man. I mean, just really fun, just really unique dudes. Yeah. To be in that set was really interesting.
Yeah. All fun to watch, though. I mean, that's the thing. It's like
all fun to watch. All fun to watch. This guy's fun to watch.
Thank you.
I want to see you wrestle, man. I want to see just wrestling.
I might have some videos, but yeah, I don't really like showing people.
I want to see them.
Rob Corddry says you should watch his wrestling videos.
Yeah. He says you were robbed of a wrestling Oscar.
Yeah, I provincials in I live in Vancouver, and in the BC provincials I got fourth this year, which is not bad, because I think my first
good as far as I'm concerned.
I think because I missed a lot of the tournaments that year, and I think I feel kind of almost kind of like a jerk, because since I've been doing it since I was three, and it's always just come naturally, and all these people have to work so hard to really develop things, and it's just kind of always felt kind of natural to me. And so I think if I had a little bit better technique and a little bit better fitness, I think I could do a little bit better.
Fitness, better, like, cross training and plyometrics and stuff.
I think I need to start.
You go to Sugar Ray's? Do you ever go over there?
You gotta go over there, man.
Your weight class?
Yeah, and another thing.
What did your weight class?
My weight class was this year was 51 kilos, which is 116 pounds, I think, and. Some people.
It's pure muscle.
It's a very demanding sport. Some people lose 10, 15 pounds, and they're in grade. They're in the 11th grade and 12th grade, and I was like, no, I lost like 2 pounds to make 51. So, yeah, I.
Yeah, that's
rough,
gnarly.
And man. And people get a lot of injuries. I've been I've never taken it so. I take it seriously, but not too seriously. Know some people who take it too seriously and. And they're out of wrestling now. They're all done.
Yeah.
They can't wrestle anymore because injuries and stuff. So.
Wow.
I think I got a good balance of it.
Tap out, bro.
Don't be like Michelle Bachman. So were you both at Sundance for this?
Yeah.
We were at Sundance. We had a great time.
Was it shocking how big the response was? I mean, it really was a huge wave of love.
It was really great. It was really surprising and beautiful. It was like. Yeah, the Eccles screening was really fantastic.
Yeah, I was really really happy for Nat and Jim, just because they put in so much into this movie over 10 years, I think it is.
Yeah.
And I was just over the moon for them
when we
heard the news. So
was it fun watching their self perform?
Yes and no.
It's weird.
I remember before a couple of scenes, the singing and the dancing scenes, I said, wait, I worked on this movie for 2 months. I know what scene's coming next. And then I sunk down to about this low in my chair, and I didn't want anybody. But it was very fun to watch, and it was a very funny movie, and I was very happy with the outcome. So.
And how were you, Sam? Were you good in the movie?
I like
it's okay.
Most of it. Yeah, I like what I see. Most of it. I there's always moments you feel like you could have made better or whatever. Yeah.
Are you comfortable like completely watching the work after you've done it?
You know, if it's good. If it's good. If it's not, you can make you cringe. Yeah.
I agree.
You can go like or you can be like, yeah, that's pretty good. You know, that was fun.
Yeah. So will you be nervous opening day for a movie like this at this point?
Not really. I don't. I mean, I've. You
I
know.
Think the movie speaks,
been through it.
Speaks for itself.
I've been through it.
I think the movie speaks for itself. And
yeah, I think it's a good movie. No matter what, it's
going to
well.
Be. Yeah, no matter what, it's going to be a great movie. So.
Yeah, it's gonna. It's gonna have a. I think it's gonna stand the test of time. You know, which is the main thing. You know.
Mm-hmm. And is that the main thing for you now when you look at scripts that you want to?
Yeah, sure. You know, I mean, that's my whole career's been like afterlife. You know, everything is always ahead. You know, most of the films I've done have had afterlife. You know, which is good. And in a way, that's, I mean, The Big Lebowski didn't do well when it came out.
No, none of the Kubrick movies.
There you
except
go. There you go.
You know, Strangelove.
Yeah,
that was the only hit when it came out.
Yeah, is that right? Yeah. So I think it's that stuff's very deceiving, you know.
But you just look for the right pieces of the puzzle, or the right character, the right.
Yeah, I think you look for it's the right part, and then the actors you're surrounded with, and the director, and the writing. You got to have like two out of three of those, you know, mm-hmm. even if you don't have all three. And then I think you can sign, get on board, you know.
And it seemed like a pretty happy movie.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody was really happy on it. Everybody had a good time.
Mm-hmm. I had a great time.
Yeah.
I had the best time. I mean,
I had a good time, man. I mean, the only down was maybe sometimes the sun got a little.
It was very hot.
It got a little hot, but other than
110
that, 110
degrees, I think.
Yeah, it was a breeze, man. It was a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
And I expect it will be fun.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I wish Sam could have stayed for the whole thing, but we had a great time at the water park together, and then the movie switched over to the beach.
The depressing stuff.
Yeah, the terrible.
With the mean with Steve Carell.
Yeah.
Okay. That meanie.
Well, you guys had more time together than any other probably individual pairing in the whole. Most of your scenes were with him.
Yeah, I all my scenes were with him and Maya. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and yeah.
I didn't get to work with Steve or Tony or Rob. You know, I didn't get to work with Amanda. I didn't get to work with those guys.
They invite you over to the beach.
Allison, I love Allison. My God, who doesn't love Allison Janney?
Yeah,
I saw a little bit of them, but not very much.
You just came in and did your thing and.
Just did my thing. I worked with Nat and Jim, and that was it.
Yeah, Nat and Jim were very.
They
did a great job in the movie.
They were fun.
I'm glad that they played the parts that they did.
Yeah, me too. They were awesome.
And I'm glad they put themselves in.
Yeah, you can really feel. You can kind of feel the happiness of the overall enterprise when you watch the movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool. That's good.
It's
glad.
A good summer song.
Yeah, yeah.